Good afternoon. I'm here with BFA. I'm here at the BFA with Mr. David Sabir. And on behalf of Digicel, we're here to announce a very exciting venture, a joint venture. Mr. Sabir, thank you for being here.
Thank you. Well, it's a pleasure to have Digicel in the home of football, the epicenter of football in Bermuda. And we are here to receive some very exciting news that will be beneficial to our participants.
Yes, so Digicel has decided to start a football fund to benefit the youth teams of Bermuda. With this fund, we'll be able to assist many clubs with the various needs that they have. We noticed that there's a need for that in the community, so we took the opportunity to get involved, and we partnered with Mr. Sabir and his team, and they've been very gracious and generous and very helpful. And we decided to allocate some funds towards these clubs that are very much in need, specifically to their youth programs.
Well, when Nigel from Digicel approached me about the establishment of this fund, clearly we were very excited on behalf of our clubs that another corporate entity in Bermuda is looking at the value and assess the value of football and its role that it plays in our community. So. From this standpoint, on behalf of the Bermuda Football Association and the many clubs that participate in the leagues that this fund is going to earmark to support, we are very thankful and very grateful, and we are certain that the clubs will use it for its intended purposes to support youth football in Bermuda.
Of course, we're very excited to come on board along with the BFA. Digicel is absolutely no stranger to sports, youth sports in particular. We partner with the Cricket Association. We have ventures in rugby as well, so it's only a natural step to go towards football and assisting where we can there. The fund will essentially be set up so that it can aid any parts of the clubs that need aiding, as far as uniforms or equipment. Anyone is eligible for it. Any club is eligible to apply for the fund. You'll write in and you'll let us know where you need assistance. And we'll go from there. Each club will receive equal opportunity, and we'll try our best to help all those that are in need, as we have a strong belief and a strong support of our youth in Bermuda.
What's the overall dollar value?
The dollar value is as high as we can go, and we'll do what we can to make sure that we can help everyone else. But Digicel has spent over $300,000 in sporting within Bermuda, so we'll see what we can do. But the overall dollar value is a good one.
You're not willing to say what the dollar value is?
I don't think the dollar value actually needs to be said. We just want to make sure that each club is able to be assisted, so it's no need to say the actual dollar value, but we will help as much as we can.
Mr. Sabir, from the association standpoint, you recently had clubs kind of vote to delay something in which they had to fill out form paperwork and have meet criteria. How confident are you that they'll be able to fulfill this in order to get what Digicel is offering?
Well, I think we have to recognize that there is an offer to support. It's not obligatory or mandatory. Digicel is extending the opportunity for clubs to write in and request funding support to enhance the programs. I am 100% confident that our clubs will take this opportunity in earnest and get in contact with Digicel and take advantage of this very worthy initiative.
And it's worth noting that the process isn't made to be complicated. It's just very straightforward. It's very simple. We made it as simple as possible for that very reason. We want to make sure that no one feels intimidated to apply. So we do hope that each club does take advantage of it, and we do look forward to receiving the paperwork.
When the initial talk started, Mr. Sabir, was there any talk about clubs in good standing or not in good standing that will be able to apply or not apply?
No, I think Digicel made it very clear that they wanted to support those clubs that have teams participating in the under 7, under 9, and under 11 age groups. I think we can say that there is never enough resource, in particular, never enough funding to support the work that the clubs do for youth football. So the BFA's position is to encourage and at the same time also lend its support in the areas of ensuring that our clubs can take advantage of as many opportunities to support what they do as possible.
And on DigiSouth's behalf, there's equal opportunity. I'm a FOGO, obviously. So obviously, you know, many people may associate me with St. George's and St. David's. However, if there is a selection process in place and there's, of course, no bias, it's an equal opportunity. And as I stated earlier, we really want every club to take advantage of it, no matter what is perceived to be their financial standing.
And DigiSouth is very good in the community as far as sporting-wise. Can we see this as a branding type venture for the company?
Well, of course, DigiSouth's brand only attaches its brand to things that they believe in, and we firmly believe in sporting, especially youth sporting, and wherever we could get our brand in and assist in whatever way possible, we're going to continue to do that.
Do all the clubs have youth programs?
The majority of our clubs, almost 95% of our clubs, have a youth team of some sort participating in the BFA's programs.
How many children do you see being affected by this?
Well, it's going to be a lot, because at the end of the day, if you look across the whole program in just these age groups, we're talking about 60-something teams. And if you add minimum of 15 players per team, that's quite a number of players that will be impacted. But more importantly, is that it helps to lessen the burden, in this case, the financial burden on our clubs. As you know, lots of them, of our clubs, utilize their own funding, personal funding, and so anything that can be done to help alleviate that stress is most beneficial.
Speak to the importance of having the business community get involved with groups like the BFA to help local sporting.
I think you know, Bermuda as a whole is generally concerned about the well-being of our country, and I think when we speak in terms of development of the whole individual, and we've heard the saying before, it takes a village to raise a child, it takes a village to keep a community together. So at the end of the day, the importance of the corporate community, and thanks to DigiSouth at this instance for supporting our clubs, is really, really significant, and hopefully, you know, more and more corporate entities see the importance of football and can use football and our clubs as a tool to improve and to improve people's lives.
Mr. Bogo, the process, once paperwork is filled out, how long do you envision the process of clubs finding out whether or not they're approved or not approved? How long do you envision that will take?
We envision that it will take 1 week. The process actually on the application form, the clubs will spot that we ask them to identify three areas of need. So as I said, we would hope that we could help each and every one that applies. We will then select from one of those areas of need, but the entire process we're hoping should take no more than 1 week from the time of receiving the application.
Is there a specific timeline for clubs to apply?
Well, the paperwork will be sent out pretty much 24 hours after this with the BFA's assistance, and they have 2 weeks from the time that they receive it to get it back to us, and then the selection process will be within that week.
Audio Jungle.